Hi everyone, welcome back to Wesknows Tech News and Reviews. Today we've got a massive accuracy test for the Huawei GT2 Pro. So today we'll be testing its SpO2 accuracy, as well as sleep accuracy, as well as resting heart rate accuracy and active heart rate accuracy. So without further ado, let's get into the testing of the Huawei GT2 Pro.
If you are new to Wesknows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
So we've actually done an initial impressions review of the Huawei GT2 Pro, and I've left the link to that at the end of this particular video, so make sure to take a look. Now, just in summary, so we've got a 1.39-inch AMOLED display here. It's sapphire glass on top. The case is actually made out of titanium. It's got a metal watch-type clasp. Looks amazing. Even on the back of it, it's not just plastic. This is a ceramic case, so you can do key charging as well as reverse charging from all the modern smartphones. Now, this thing here has inbuilt GPS. It's 50 meters water resistant. It's got 90 sport modes. It's got 13 guided workouts for your running and general fitness. There is so much to talk about here. There's continuous stress monitoring, continuous SpO2 monitoring, continuous heart rate tracking, breathing exercises, and so much more. But again, you can look at all of that in the review that we've done earlier on. Now, let's talk about the testing. So how I've actually structured this video. First, we'll talk about SpO2 accuracy, because we've actually compared the Huawei GT2 Pro's results against a medical grade SpO2 device, or blood oxygen saturation monitor. Then we'll talk about sleep accuracy. Then we'll talk about the resting heart rate, so the heart rate during night or during hours of rest. And then we'll talk about active heart rate accuracy. There I've actually used the Polar H10 ECG chest strap as the basis or the benchmark for the accurate heart rate. And of course, the two pros, the GT2 Pro's optical heart rate sensor will be plotted against that. And we'll see what we came up with. So without further ado, let's get into the SpO2 accuracy test. Now the medical grade SpO2 monitor has actually shown us that over 5 hours and 52 minutes, so that's of recorded time, we can see the average SpO2 level being 91%. And do consider the fact that this medical grade device actually takes a reading every 1 second. So over 6 hours, there were over 3,500 data points. This is massive. And we can see the chart there. So there was one massive drop at the early hours of the night. Now let's take a look at what the Huawei GT2 Pro came up with. Now, as we can see, the GT2 Pro actually also has shown a very low result in the early hours of the night, but the overall average over the night and early morning, the range is actually 86 to 100%, meaning that it does register that one bar where we had an extra low result, and that is fine. So what that gives us, 100 minus 86 gives us 14, 14 divided by 2, is 7. 86 plus 7 is 93. So the GT2 Pro is actually showing us the average SpO2 level at 93% over the night and early morning of the 11th of July, while the medical grade device is giving us 91%. Okay, so we are off by approximately 2%. But do consider this, that the medical grade SpO2 ring has actually been on me for just 6 hours, while the GT2 Pro has actually calculated all the way through the night plus the early hours of the morning. And we can see that in the early morning, SpO2 numbers have actually gone above 94 to 95 and 96, and that has actually pulled up the average. Now also, in regards to SpO2 readings or measurements taken by the GT2 Pro, so if on the SpO2 ring, the measurements are taken every 1 second, on the 2 Pro, you get a reading every 10 minutes. So within 30 minutes or one bar on the chart, there will be only 3 readings. Another important health reading is your resting heart rate. And if we actually take a look at the SpO2 ring and what has shown us during the night, we can see that for the time of 5 hours and 52 minutes during the night, the SpO2 ring has actually measured the resting heart rate of 65 beats per minute. And on the Huawei GT2 Pro, you also see a resting heart rate of 65 beats per minute. That is spot on. So another great result. Now let's take a quick look at sleep accuracy. Now most of the Huawei smartwatches and fitness bands actually come along with TruSleep technology. Now this technology was actually done in conjunction with the Harvard Medical School. And we know that the Huawei watches actually monitor your sleep and report three sleep stages. So your light, your deep and REM sleep. Also, when you look onto the watch face, you'll be able to see the summary or the total time you've actually slept. But when you go to the app, you'll be able to see much more detail. You'll be able to get a breakdown of your sleep and your sleep patterns. You'll be also seeing guidance on how to actually improve your sleep quality. So now if we take a look at the chart from the Huawei Health app, we can see that we've slept for 5 hours and 30 minutes. So went to sleep rather late at 3:30 a.m. but woke up at just after 9 a.m. Now here was a bit of a trick question that I actually posed to myself. So we can see that there is a wake up time at 8 a.m. and that is true because I did set two alarms, one for 8 a.m. and one for 9 a.m. So I did wake up at 8 a.m. but I didn't actually get up. I went back to sleep for another hour and we can see that the watch picked up the wake up time. It has shown that I was awake for about 5 minutes and then I fell back asleep and actually got up at 9 a.m. So I think this was definitely a pass. Now let's get on to the exciting test. So the active heart rate accuracy test. So what I've done here is I've actually used the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So this goes around my chest and as I'm doing exercises, it basically takes on ECG readings from this band right here, which goes around my chest. So I was exercising for just under half an hour. I went on the treadmill and I jogged for about 1.5 kilometers. After that, I jumped off and carried on with weight exercises. And in between sets, I would do some core strength exercises, something like squats or abs. So there I was trying to keep up the heart rate and actually make a good varied exercise to show you the dynamic ranges that can be picked up with the Polar H10 as well as the GT2 Pro. So how we're actually going to show you this is first we're going to be using the plot or the heart rate plot from the ECG chest strap and over it we'll be plotting the heart rate from the GT2 Pro. Okay. So what we can see from the ECG chest strap is that it has actually recorded the average heart rate at 125 beats per minute over the exercise, while the max was 151 beats per minute. With the GT2 Pro, using the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the watch here, we actually see the average coming in at 123 beats per minute and the max at 146 beats per minute. So what we see is an understatement on the average as well as the peak. So on the average, we see an understatement of 2 beats per minute, which equates to 1.6%. While on the peak, we actually have an underestimate from the heart rate sensor on the GT2 Pro by 5 beats per minute. And that gives us a slightly larger difference of 3.3%. But nonetheless, a difference that is under 5% is considered negligible. Especially due to the fact that the ECG chest strap is always on you and it's right above the heart. So it does get the most accurate pulse readings. Now, with the optical heart rate sensor on the back of a smartwatch, having readings which are within 5% of the ECG chest strap is an amazing result. So really what we can see is that the Huawei GT2 Pro has a very high accuracy level. So in regards to SpO2, it's almost like for like with a medical grade SpO2 monitor. Also, it reports on your sleep highly accurately. So you know when you went to sleep, you know when you woke up, and it doesn't really muffle in those results when you can wake up, but you go back to sleep. Also, there's a detailed breakdown of your sleep pattern within the Huawei Health app. And you can read the recommendations to actually improve your sleep quality. In regards to heart rate, well, I think we've proven it. In regards to medical grade accuracy, so the resting heart rate, 65 beats per minute. exactly the same as measured by the medical grade device. If we talk about the active heart rate, so we can see that the ECG chest strap and the actual watch or the heart rate sensor, the optical heart rate sensor on the back of the watch, are within 1.6% for the average and 3.3% of the max. All of these results do point to the fact that the GT2 Pro is a trusted device. Anyway, thank you for watching this accuracy test of the Huawei GT2 Pro. If you did enjoy the content, please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Please click the red subscribe button below the video. And we'll see you in the next one.